Good day, everyone. My name is Sheikha Kena Salvasa, and I will continue to discuss the Rutter and Michelle Cognitive Social Learning Theory. And for the outline, I will discuss the introduction to Michelle personality system, biography of Walter Michelle, background of the cognitive affective personality system, cognitive affective personality system, concept of humanity. Introduction to Michelle personality system. Like Bandura and Rutter, Michelle believes that cognitive factors such as expectancies, subjective perceptions, values, goals, and personal standards are important in shaping personality. In his early theory, Michelle seriously questioned the consistency of personality, but more recently, he and Yuichi Shoda have advanced the notion that behavior is also a function of relatively stable cognitive affective units. Rutter and Michelle can also be seen as having encompassed Bandura's career. Although all three men were active during the same general time frame, Rutter's first book on social learning theory preceded Bandura's first book by 5 years. Michelle, a student of Rutter and then a colleague of Bandura for a while, has continued to modify his most influential theory quite recently in the 1990s and 2000s. Rutter and Michelle can also be considered as providing a bridge between the more traditional social learning theory of Bandura and the full-fledged cognitive theory of George Kelly. Kelly was Rutter's colleague at Ohio State University, and Michelle studied under both men while in graduate school. Thus, social learning theory, cognitive social learning theory, and cognitive theories of personality development all occurred in close relationship to one another, and they all offered a dramatic alternative to radical behaviorism, an alternative that helped to fulfill the vision of John Dollard and Neil Miller. Walter Michelle was born in 1930 in a comfortable home where he enjoyed a pleasant childhood. They lived in Vienna, a short distance from Sigmund Freud's house. However, when the Nazis invaded Austria at the beginning of World War II, the Michelle family moved to the United States, eventually settling in New York City. In college, Michelle studied to become a social worker. While working as a social worker in the Lower East Side slums, Michelle attended City College of New York and pursued a graduate degree in clinical psychology. He had been taught that Freud's theory offered the best explanation of human behavior, but he did not find this to be true in his work with juvenile delinquents, or the same practical conclusion occurred to Carl Rogers in his first clinical position. Then he attended Ohio State University, where he was a graduate student of both Julian Rutter and George Kelly. Rutter and Kelly helped to firmly establish Michelle as a member of the General Social Learning or Cognitive Learning Camp, and later Michelle became a faculty member at Stanford University, alongside Albert Bandura. From 1962 to 1983, then he returned to New York as a faculty member at Columbia University, where he continued his work on delayed gratification and the effects of situations on personal behavior. Michelle had been recognized with a Distinguished Scientific Contribution Award with the American Psychological Association. Michelle originally believed that human behavior was mostly a function of the situation, but more lately, he has recognized the importance of relatively permanent cognitive affective units. Nevertheless, Michelle's theory continues to recognize the apparent inconsistency of some behaviors. Consistency paradox. The consistency paradox refers to the observation that although both lay people and professionals tend to believe that behavior is quite consistent, research suggests that it is not. Michel recognizes that indeed, some traits are consistent over time, but he contends that there is little evidence to suggest that they are consistent from one situation to another. Additional information about this consistency paradox is that a person's behavior seems consistent or the same every time you see them, but in a given situation, their behavior can change from consistent state to a completely different state than used to. For example, kaila ni mo nga kanang consistent kay siya nga mag-study sa kanang pinakasugod, pero pag abot sa tunga-tunga, mukalit lang siyang undang ana, unya pagkahuman na kay mamagsak. Next is person-situation interaction. Michel believes that behavior is best predicted from an understanding of the person, the situation, and the interaction between person and situation. Thus, behavior is not the result of some global personality trait, but rather of people's perception of themselves in a particular situation. Michel's meaning of this is that a person can be distinguished from a given situation rather than just assuming how they act. For example, kanang tao nga kanang nagyaw-yaw siya kay mali ang iyang nakuha nga order. Makaingon ta nga kaning tawhana ni gamay lang ni siya og pasensya pero wala pud ta kabalo basig stress or gigutom na pud siya. Next topic is cognitive affective personality system. However, Michel does not believe that inconsistencies in behavior are due solely to the situation. He recognized that inconsistent behaviors reflect stable patterns of variation within a person. He and Shoda see these stable variations in behavior in the following framework: if A, then X, but if B, then Y. People's pattern of variability is their behavioral signature or their unique and stable pattern of behaving differently in different situations. Behavior prediction. Individuals should behave differently as situations vary. Michel's basic theoretical position for predicting and explaining behavior is as follows. If personality is a stable system that processes information about the situation, then individuals encountering different situations should behave differently as situations vary. Therefore, Michel believes that even though people's behavior may reflect some stability over time, it tends to vary as situations vary. Michel identified 5 such units. First are encoding strategies or people's individualized manner of categorizing information they receive from external stimuli. Second are the competencies and self-regulatory strategies. One of the most important of these competencies is intelligence, which Michel argues is responsible for the apparent consistency of other traits. In addition, people use self-regulatory strategies to control their own behavior through self-formulated goals and self-produced consequences. The third cognitive affective units are expectancies and beliefs, or people's guesses about the consequences of each of the different behavioral possibilities. The fourth cognitive affective unit includes people's subjective goals and values, which tend to render behavior fairly consistent. Michel's fifth cognitive affective unit includes affective responses, including emotions, feelings, and affect that accompanies physiological reactions. Concept of humanity. Rother and Michel see people as goal-directed cognitive animals whose perceptions of events are more crucial than the events themselves. Cognitive social learning theory rates very high on social influences and high on uniqueness of the individual, free choice, teleology, and conscious process. On the dimension of optimism versus pessimism, Rother's view is slightly more optimistic, whereas Michel is about in the middle. So that's the end of my report. Thank you for listening and have a good day.